baskets. They're going to grab their toes. They're going to take their elbows to their ears. Good. If you want to learn how to do basket, you can refer to another video. So we're going to practice within these baskets rocking forwards and backwards. Okay, this also just gets them used to the position that they're going to be in and the momentum that, and the power that they're going to need in order to hold this chest balance. Good, and relax. Okay, from there, we're going to take it up to our knees, and you want to practice your preparation for your chest balance. So it's easiest, I think, personal preference, to open our knees as wide as possible, yeah? And we're going to have our hands placed right in front of our thighs so that the first thing that touches the mat are your hands and not your chin, okay? You want to lean back as far as possible, pressing the pelvis forward, okay? You know, just drop down and then come right back up into cobra to hold, okay? So this would be the next thing that you want to teach your students. So again, they're on their knees. They're going to open their hands, press down into their hands, into the mat, and then roll down and back up into cobra to hold. Okay? As they progress, you want to try to get your students to hold their chest balance for a few counts longer. So we're going to hold this one for a few counts. So they roll down, and they're going to hold it for a little while, and then they come right back down. Good. And you can have them do it with straight legs or with bent knees, toes to their head. Okay? From there, we're going to do the toes to our head. You want to start practicing to spot your students. Make sure that they have the proper preparation, like they're rolling down before you start spotting your students. So they're going to roll down. From here, I'm just going to scoop underneath their knees, right? I want to make sure that they're lifting their hips up instead of sitting in their back, and then I'm going to just hold onto their knees. And from there, I'm going to say, okay, so lean on me. So lean back there. This is where a lot of kids are first. I'm going to say, okay, try to lift your knees off of my hands. Oh, there she goes. Okay, so that's going to teach them how to activate their hamstrings and their glutes and their back, right? In order to hold the position. So, once they master that, when you can take your hands away, they can pull those knees forward. They can move on to the next one, which is to just practice by themselves in holding, okay? So go ahead and do one more. Just hold it as long as you can. So she's going to bend her toes to the head. Yes. Okay, and then quickly we'll just talk about how to get those toes to the floor. Go ahead and relax. Okay, it's also personal preference. This works for some dancers, this doesn't for others. You want to bring your hands, once you get into your chest balance position, you want to bring your hands close together and create this bowl in your chest, right? So you've got a pressure, you've got weight on your shoulders and your chin here. So this hollowed out space helps you to breathe while you're in that position. Okay, so from there, you then want to lift your hips up to the ceiling so that those feet go further over. So Masha's going to demonstrate quickly. She's going to roll down into her chin stand. Go ahead and bend. So from there, she's hollowed out her chest so she can breathe. She's going to lift her butt up to the ceiling, and then she takes those toes over. Okay, she can do it by herself, but that's just going to help your students lift up into a nice arch versus sitting and pinching their backs. Okay, while they're trying to get their toes onto the floor. So I hope